Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Skyward Sword. In the last episode, we started working on a big puzzle. We have to activate three keys, and we activated one so far. We got a tumbleweed right here. The other two keys, we're gonna have to do like a mini dungeon for each one of the other two. So that's pretty much what we're gonna be doing in this episode. Also, I figured out there's a piece of heart not too far from here, so we're gonna be getting that too, and I believe that completes a heart container. Let's check. Yep, that will complete a heart container, so that's good. Making that sweet progress. Actually, let's just forget about these. There's nothing actually there. We're gonna go ahead and bomb this rock, and there's a time stone there. So yeah, these are just mini dungeons. They're like one or two rooms. I guess two or three rooms if you count like the past version as like its own room, which it kind of is, but it kind of isn't. But whatever. So these guys in the past were like that, I suppose. Oh look, there's a thing to dig here. I didn't even know that was there. Let's see, what are we gonna do? We're gonna go over here. Probably ignore that guy because, well, he's ignoring me. And I figured out this really cool strategy. You can hit these guys with a Skyward Strike and just like instant kill them. Just look at that. It's so good. But what are we gonna do? Well, we have to open this door. I'm gonna use this beetle here. This is the easiest way. And I'm gonna drop him right there. All right. So this will let us open the door. It kind of powers the door. Yes, V, I know how to do this. Yes, analysis, restore the device, requires energy. These things are energy. I should have waited. Yeah, be careful that they don't electrocute you. But this will open the door, and we can activate the second key. This happened much quicker than I thought it would. There's also some things here. I think we can get some bombs around here. Once again, we're gonna need a lot of bombs this episode. Did I say we needed a lot of bombs in this episode, or was that the recording that I tried to do before doing this recording? You see, sometimes a recording just goes so terribly, you have to do another recording. All right. Doesn't look like there's any treasures in here, so we can just leave. That means I ran out of things to talk about. Oh, there is a chest here. Silly, silly map, you lied to me. The chest right here. I mean, it only has 5 rupees, but you totally lied to me, map. But yeah, I'm recording this on Saturday and hopefully uploading on Saturday. In like any minute now, Proton John will be beginning his subscriber night stream. And I'm a subscriber of his, like Twitch subscriber. So I don't want to miss that, especially since I voted on a game already. So it would be pretty terrible if I couldn't actually be there. I mean, I doubt he'll like pick my game first, so. Alright, we're gonna do that. This will just let us, know where to go. I mean, I don't really need to explain that. You guys already know about that. Let's see. That thing we want to do is this away. As you can see, there's a crack in the wall over there. Also, there's a dog barking in the background. I don't know if you can hear that. You probably can, maybe. I don't know. I'm gonna try to see if I can get rid of that in post. Yeah, it's not actually my dog, it's the neighbor's dog, so don't blame me. But there's a cave here, and on the other end of this tunnel is a heart piece. We're gonna be ignoring like all of these guys because I don't like them and they're annoying. Because electric type enemies are always just the worst. Not talking about Pokemon, of course, I'm talking about, in this game. Although, when I play Pokemon, I don't often use electric types, but anyways, is that the first time I've ever talked about Pokemon on this channel? I think it might actually be, because I don't actually play that much Pokemon, just like some of it. My I think my 3DS like automatically downloaded that new Pokemon Rumble thing, Pokemon Rumble World. My first Pokemon game was actually Pokemon Rumble, like the first one on the Wii, and it was a demo, and that was my first experience. Unless you count, you know, watching YouTube videos, but yeah, I'm not very experienced with said Pokemon. But anyways, oh, that was bad idea in half. I forgot to wait for two refill. There we go. Link is all nice and rested. But yeah, we have a full heart container. And is that 10? I believe we have 10 now. I don't feel like counting because I kind of have to pay attention to what's going on. But if we continue this way, there's a few things we can do, such as make a shortcut. I always like making shortcuts in games. It's just fun. It's a sense of progress. Because in the last episode, we were on the other side of this wall, but now we can just go back and forth whenever we want to. There's a bird statue here, which we'll probably be using after we finish this little area. I don't think we're actually gonna try doing the generator thing because I didn't practice for that. I mean, I could probably figure it out, not too much trouble, but anyways, let's see, let's just get rid of this guy. Excuse me. Nope. I accidentally moved the Wii remote. Alright. Over here you can actually read some of the signs. How many times have I said actually? Probably a lot. It's a common word. I noticed that I say it a lot, but not everybody says it a lot, so I don't know if it's just me. Maybe it is. Okay, let's go over here. There is a time stone. I'm gonna just move out of the way. This should be good enough, right? Right? Nope, it's not good enough. But I'm not sinking, so that's good. We're not gonna activate it yet. Instead, wow, really? You couldn't make it over last time. Alright, we're gonna... Actually, I probably could have used that. So, oh well. We got 10 bombs here. And come over here. Get over here. Alright, we're gonna wait till he gets stunned. We're gonna do that. And then we're gonna trick shot it because the bomb will not go off in time. So that's what I do. It's a little complicated. And you need like some good reflexes, but that's what I like to do. I just like taking out the slingshot and just attacking the bomb. It works out really well. And they even give you slingshot ammo, so I mean, they probably intend for you to do that. Alright, do we get anything from this? I forget. Nope, we got literally nothing. Not even like a green rupee. That was a waste of time. Much like getting electrocuted is a waste of time. Let's go and let's see what's in here. Something good? We got some Eldenor. Okay, that's pretty good. We're not coming across that very often. Actually, you know what? We're not even in Elden. Why is there Eldenor here? Oh, that's weird. But this will let us once again create a shortcut because I just love creating shortcuts. But we actually need that shortcut. And I died. Alright, let's try this again. Hit the time stone, Link. Yeah, he kept knocking me over, so I just cut it out. Those guys are, like, incredibly annoying. Probably my least favorite enemy in the entire game. Like, they're that annoying. I'm just gonna do that and knock them off. That was funny to do. Alright. And we're gonna... Nope. That was pretty weird. I hit him a lot, and he... Nothing... Why is this guy not dying? Alright, there. He took way more hits than, like, every other guy ever. Alright, blue rupee. Yeah, whatever. I just kind of wanted to get him out of the way so he didn't bother me while I was doing this. Because we're gonna do this again. Just go ahead and grab that. Also, I'd like to point out that this area kind of looks like that one area in Paper Mario. You know, the toy box level. That's it's a fun level. And speaking of Paper Mario, it's finally available on the Wii U. Because for some reason, it took Nintendo a million years to put N64 games on the Wii U. I don't know why it took them so long. It couldn't have been that difficult, but they finally did. Maybe they were trying to figure out the save state stuff, but I mean, that shouldn't have been too difficult. But whatever. I'm done talking about Wii U N64 stuff. Before we get that, let's go over here and grab some Treasure. Treasure being also a game company that I like a lot. Got a monster horn, not a monster claw, so it's a separate collectible. We only have one so far. These are a bit more difficult to get than monster claws, so. And once again, just 5 rupees. Hardly even worth the time to grab. Let's just turn this, push it in, and we've activated all 3 of these. This one's fire. Last one was electricity. And now we can do this puzzle, and I'll show you guys how the puzzle is done in the next episode. But first, Fee is all like, oh, all 3 are activated. You can use the mining facility generator. Alright, thanks for letting me know, even though I know that. Is there anything else here to do? I think there's like a treasure chest that we could probably find. Let's actually look at the map for a second. There's like, we got those. We're done. We're done here. We can just leave and end the episode, and that should be it. So, thank you all for watching this episode of Skyward Sword. In the next episode, we're going to activate that generator, because we spent an entire episode unlocking the generator, so of course we're going to activate it. Because otherwise, all these episodes would just be pretty pointless. So, see you guys then.